Okay, in yesterday's class we discussed about the data types. We completed the data types also. Okay, that is it is one of the important topic in the Python, that is data type. We have discussed the five type of data types we have seen. One second for recap, we will do it. What are the things we have discussed? Can anyone say means I will be happy. What are the things we discussed? I mean data types I'm asking. Yes, please. What are the data types are there? Integer. Yes. Integer data type. In the integer, there is numeric data type. Numbers. The numbers itself subclassified into three types: integer, floating point, and complex number. Okay. The again the integer having subclassification, that is boolean and signed int also we can use it. Okay. And then next is string data type, list, tuple, dictionary. Okay, these are all the things we have seen, and we have seen which are all the mutable data type, which is which are all not mutable. Okay, that is immutable. Okay, changeable and not changeable values. Okay, this we have seen an overview, and today we are going to see about the some more interesting about the variables. Okay, how to know the data type of a variable? One variable is given. What is the data type of the variable? Okay. Where the actually where in computer the value is stored, okay, by using the ID function. Okay, what is the value of that? That also we are going to see. Is it my audio is clear and screen also is clear for you? Because I'm getting one message likewise.
Yes, sir.
Sorry, if you're having any trouble, means please let me know it. Okay, so I will just showing this instead of the slide. I will take to the Python prompt and I will show to. I'm going to teach the three functions we are going to see. Okay, three key attributes. Okay, three key attributes means type. Okay, for example, a equal to 100. Suppose we are storing a value. Okay, a equal to 100 means 100 is a value. A is a variable. Okay, and we are using the one assignment operator. Okay, this is the one constraint. This is one example. If you are taking means, what is the data type of a? A equal to 100 we stored. What is the data type of a? Whether it is a string or floating point or boolean value or what is the data type? Hello, a is contain 100. No, that is a integer data. No, so integer its type. Okay, what is the value of a? A is one variable. The a contain what is the value? 100 is the value. That is by using the value function we can come to know it. Okay, we will get it. Okay, then id, where actually in which memory address it is stores. The value is stored literally in the computer. So by getting the memory ID, we can get it. Okay, these three things only we are going to discuss. Okay, let I will open the Python prompt. For your case, I'm just opening the Windows. Just to click the start button, and you can see this. Go to the scroll down to the Python 3.8, and just open the IDLE. Just those who are having computer, you must install the Python. That will be easy for you, and it will be. What is the thing? If you are practiced well, means it will be easy for you whenever you are doing the program. That's what I'm coming to tell. Okay, you just open it. Then the first thing it will open is an interactive mode. This is interactive mode. For example, I will type for your case interactive mode. For example, a equal to 100. I'm just giving. Okay, enter. That's all. Okay, next line. Suppose I want to know what is the value stored in a. Suppose. Okay, for that I have to use value function. Okay, value is a value. Value of a, suppose I given, means you can see. Oh, okay. Show the wrong. Okay. Value is not different. 1 minute. 1 minute. Of course, value is an object. Let me see an example. You can see this. It's not showing. Type and value is there. But it is not working. Let me see this. Let me reminding the two things we will do it. ID and the type type function. 1 minute. I will open the screen. Okay. Suppose I want to know the type of A. What is the data type which is stored in the things means? Type. Okay. 1 minute. Type of A. Suppose I given this where things means A. Then you can come to know it is returning integer. That is class int. It is returning no. So class int means what? The a is containing integer data type. Okay. Suppose in which memory address it is stored. So if you want to know the memory address means we can use the id function. Id is one of the function. Id of a, okay, a is a variable, no? So if you use this means, see in my computer the 100 is stored in which location? See this memory location, I mean 140, likewise the big number it is. So in this in that memory location the id, that is the variable 100 is stored, that is the value 100 is stored. Have you understand type an id function? That is enough. Have you understood? Hello. Type an id function, that is very important. Okay, so I hope you understand the type an id function. Once again, if you want means I will just do for you. You can see
so
this.
One second.
Yes, I will do it. For example, can you say one variable? Can you say any one variable? For example, I'm just using CS equal to 100.589. Suppose this is the value. Okay. What is the variable? CS equal to 100.589. This is the variable. Okay. The variable contains the value. Okay. Suppose I want to know the memory ID, where actually literally the 100.589, where it is stored in my computer. Suppose I want to know means I have to use ID function. ID is a function. Function is parenthesis. Then I have to give the variable. What is variable? CS is a variable, isn't it?
Yes.
CS equal to only, no. So if I give enter, you can see the 100.589 is stored in this memory address. It will be vary to machine to machine. In your mobile, it will show different number. In my computer, because it is where it is stored in our computer, that is the matter. No, that's what. Okay. Suppose I want to know the what is the data type of the variable CS. Okay. So how to come to know means type function. TYPE. Type is one of the function. Type of variable name. CS is a variable name. No. So if I give means, you can see it is returning what? Class float. Float it is returning. Because 100.589 is what type of data? Floating point, no. It is a decimal number, no. There is fractional number, no. That's what it is showing, float. Suppose I am giving 100.00 also, it will return fold. Point is there means it is a float. Okay, I will just use another one example. Again, A equal to, I'm using the string data type, okay. Computer, it is a string, no. A enclosed in single quote or double quote. I'm using this type of A. Can see it will string str. Str means string. Okay. Str means string data type. Okay. Have you understand what is the use of interactive mode? Now we understand. No? So far we done in the script mode only. This is the interactive mode. For anything you want to get a one line command, two lines commands, if you want to type means, you will go with the interactive mode. Okay. For instantly, if you want to get anything means, you can go with the interactive mode. For program purpose means, you have to go with the script mode. Okay. How to open the script mode? I already thought that. Click the file and click the new file. Okay. The new window will come. Here you have to type the program. Have you understand this? Suppose let me go to the next one also. Yeah. Somebody having doubt? Yes, please. Yes. I'm waiting for your reply. Have you understand this? For example, I'm just typing another one. A equal to, okay, before A was a computer, now I'm just creating a list. How to create a list? Square bracket, no? Square bracket, then I'm just giving 4.6, and then I'm just giving another one, computer. So whatever data type, I can just give it, okay, and close the square bracket. That is a A value now. So if I type the, what is the data type of A means, you can see, it is a list. It's containing. It is clearly showing, no? It is a list. Tuple means how to represent tuple. I already shared the slide in our website also. Kindly go through it. I have sending the message daily once. It is not for anybody things. For your sake only, I'm just sending. Because many of them, I know that you are not having the book. So just get the book properly. Till that, you just maintain with the materials. Okay. Many teachers in some other subject and all, they will give the material by posting there in the image, or they may dictate it. They are giving the running notes. But I'm just sharing every PPT into the PDF file and I posted in our website also. Okay. So just kindly go through it and write down this essential definitions from the slide. Okay. At least keep the slide, download it to your mobile or PC, that is computer, and read it. okay, that will be easy for you, and refer the videos, okay, in order to get the complete knowledge about that. That's what I'm saying. Okay, suppose this is the way we have to use the ID function and type function. Have you all understand that, how to use ID function and type function? Hello, children.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, if anybody has doubt, means please ask. I hope. Shall we go to the next one? Okay, evaluating the logical expression. Okay, logical expression, before that, everything having the precedence. Okay, logical operator, three type of logical operators are there, and, are, and not. Okay, the three things are the logical operator we have seen in the previous slide. Okay, suppose the for example, 10 divided by 5 or 5.0. suppose if it is, means it will be evaluated plus 50 divided by 10. For example, R operator, if it is, means first preference is goes to the AND operator, then R operator. That is the thing. NOT operator, there is among that, first is NOT, then AND, then R. Okay, that is for after that, some slides are there. From that, you can easily understand the operator precedence on concept is there. After that, you can understand it. So, have you understand now the type function? Sorry, type function and ID function. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
That will be very easy. Let me go to the next one. Type casting. Cast means we are just changing from one data type to another data type. Okay, here that is called as type conversion. Okay, type conversion, otherwise called as type casting. Another name also there. This is called type casting, is otherwise called as explicit type conversion. Explicit means we are changing by forcibly, users giving the force in order to change the from one data type to another data type. Two type of conversions are there. Implicit type conversion, explicit type conversion. Implicit means program itself automatically it will convert. Okay, that is called what? Implicit. Okay, automatically the program, the interpreter will change the data type. That is called implicit type conversion. Explicit means we are wanted that forcibly changing into another data type. Let I will show an example. You can see that. Maximize the screen also too. Okay, here last line. Can you able to see the interactive prompt?
Yes, sir.
For example, A equal to 10. Okay, then B equal to, I'm just giving 5. Okay, A divided by 5. What will be the data type? A divided by 5. What is the data type of suppose C? I am just giving it. C equal to A divided by B. Okay, what is the data type of C? It is not integer. It should be automatically, it will convert into the decimal. I will show that. Print C. I'm just giving, sorry. Oh, print of C. Print of C. Now you can see that. So 2.0 will be the answer. Have you understand this? 2.0 will be the output. Okay. Would you able to see that? So, for example, type of C, if I ask, means it will return float. Okay. For example, A is 10. It is an integer. B is 5. That is also integer, isn't it? I'm selecting now. You can see this. A equal to 10. B equal to 5. Both A variable and B variable is integer. But automatically, the program will, whenever we are doing the division, automatically it will convert into the decimal data type. That is float data type. Have you understand this? This type of conversion automatically will convert. We are giving two integer value, then what will be the output also? It must be also integer, no? For example, if I divide, means 2 want to be the output, no? But output is what? 2.0. That is the output. Okay, that is very carefully you should note down. Okay, this type of automatically it will convert. Okay, from integer data, 2 is equal to 2.0 only. Am I right? 2 also same, 2.0 also same. But what is the thing? Data type is different. 2 is integer data type. 2.0 means what? Floating data type. Have you understand? So entire data will be changed from that concept. Okay. This type of conversion is called as implicit type conversion. Implicit type conversion. Okay. Automatically the program will convert the one data type to another data type. This is a definition. You can note it down also. Implicit type conversion means the program, that is the interpreter, the interpreter automatically convert the one data type to another data type. This is called implicit type conversion. Okay, two type of type conversion is there. One is implicit type conversion. Another one is explicit type conversion. What is the another name for explicit type conversion? Means typecasting. Okay, typecasting. Okay, typecasting is otherwise called as explicit. Explicit type conversion. What is the use of explicit type conversion, sir? Suppose it is returning. What is the C value? Can you say that? What is the C value? What is stored in the C?
2.0.
What is the data type of C?
Decimal.
That is, you can see here in this Python. We should not say decimal, no? It is what? Float data type, isn't it? 2.0 is floating data type, no? Is it correct? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now I want it. I don't need to want in the float data type. I want only the integer value. I'm forcing. That is, we are the user. We are forcing the compiler or the interpreter in order to change the data type. Let I will see how to convert means int of C. I'm just changing it. Before I'm just giving that type of C I typed, it is returning float. Okay. Now I'm just giving int of C. You can see this. Now it is showing 2. Okay. If I use the type of C now, what will return? Integer. Sorry. Now it is float, but we are converting into the C into the integer. Before it was returned print. I will show that. Once again, I will show that. Print for your understanding. Better your understanding. Int of C. Previously, you can see in print of C is given. I am just printing the C value. It is printing 2. Okay. Now I am just changing print of int of C. The C value will be converted into int. Then it will print. Okay. Now I will show that. It is showing the 2. Have you understand that? We are converting. Have you understand? From 2.0 to
it's we are
converting into 2. Okay. Suppose the result will be 2.5. If I convert into the integer data type, means what? It will return 2 only. The 0.5 will be omitted. Okay. So this is the one of the disadvantage. What is the thing? Accuracy will be loose. We will lose the accuracy. 2.0, it's okay. Suppose 2.3 is 2.5, 2.9 is the value we are getting means. Suppose in some operation. Okay. 2, it will return into the 2. No. So 2 is equal to 2.9. It's entirely different. It's almost to the number 3. Isn't it? So that is the one of the disadvantage of explicit type conversion or type casting is it will the data will lose the accuracy. The result will lose the accuracy. That is the thing. Okay. Have you understand what is type casting?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, now if you read the definition means you can understand. Yes, sir. Okay, explicit type conversion is user defined conversion. We are defining. We want it. Okay. Conversion that forces, we are forcing an expression to be a specific type. So I no need float data type. I need the result want only to print in the float integer data type means I want to give the inside the print statement int of the variable. Okay. Then the variable will be print only the integer data type. Okay. The explicit type conversion is also known as type casting. What is another name for explicit type conversion means type casting. Okay. Another one we have discussed, that is implicit type conversion. Implicit type conversion means automatically the computer will, that is the interpreter will divide it. It will convert it. For that only I have shown an example. A equal to 10, B equal to 5. Okay, result should be 2 only, no? That is both are integer value, but is returning what? In which data type? Floating data type. But we given the two values is integer, how the float number is coming? Automatically it will type it. Which one? The interpreter will type. That type of converting is called as what? Implicit type conversion. Now this is we need in certain data type, that is explicit conversion. I will show once again one more example. A equal to, I'm just giving 100. Suppose this is the one value. You can see in the last one, I'm just showing the space for your understanding. Okay. A equal to 100. You can see in the top. Top means not in the top of the screen. The selected one. A equal to 100. What is the data type of A? Hello, what is the
integer?
Integer, correct? No. Suppose I want to convert into string data type. Is it possible? Of course, we are forcing it. Okay. How to force means, one minute. How to do that means you can see now I'm just typing it print or else A equal to, okay. string of, we want to convert into string data type, no? So str, string data type means str, str of a. Okay, a equal to str of a. What is already a? A is 100. It is an integer data type that will be converted into string data type. Then that is again stored in the same variable a. Okay, now you can see, now if I print the a data type, means you can see, sorry, type of a, if I ask, means you can see that it is converted into str. Have you understand that?
Str.
Yeah. Because we are converting. We are converting into the another data type. Even though a values be given 100, it is an integer data type. We are forcibly, I no need the 100 want to be in integer data type. I want it should be in string data type, means we can do it. Okay, we can convert it. Again, we are storing the same variable a. Okay. Now, if I want to suppose I am just giving that print of a, I am just giving, you can see how the value will be printed. You can see this 100 is there, but what is the data type of a mean? That is same thing only, but the type is different. Data, no, that's what you can understand it. I understood your point. You can see this type of a, if you give, means it is a string data type. We are forcing it to convert it, converting data type alone, not the value. Try to understand, we are not changing the value, but data type is different. Okay, that is the concept. Okay, let me go to the next one. Typecasting, have you understand? And type conversion, have you understand? We are converting from one data type to another data type. That is called we are in whichever we required format. I need only in the floating data type. I need the result 1, 2 only in the integer data type or string data type. Whatever thing, it is possible. Okay, that is the concept. Let me see the next one. Okay, and we are going to see about the math library. It is another concept in the Python. Okay, library. What is library means? Can you say what is library generally in our school or in our public library? What's in your mind about library means?
Last of books in
that. Very good. Very good. Library means it contains lot of books, magazines, newspapers, dailies, everything, isn't it? So people will come and they will refer the books, and a number of books are there in all the department wise. That is all the field wise, it will be there. So which book we need to refer it, we can easily go and refer it, isn't it? So that is the thing here in Python. Library is a collection of function definition. Okay, it contains already the functions are defined. What is function, sir? If you're asking, means the function is a predefined code. What is function means? It is a predefined code. Okay. Suppose I want to find a number. I want to do one operation, do one task, means already the code is defined. Okay. So the functions, what is function means? I am saying it's a predefined code for to do a specific task. Okay. For doing a specific task, the code is already written. We didn't write already whenever the Python who developed, no, that is a Kaido Van Rossum and his team members already developed the, what is the thing, the code for that. Okay, that codes and all be collection. Likewise, all the functions will be collected and they are storing in a library. Okay, here one library is there, that is named as math library. Have you understand? Have you got some idea about that? What is library? What is math library means? So math library is one of the library. Likewise, n number of libraries are there in Python. Okay, so math library is one of the library. In that, mathematical related functions are stored. Mathematical relations function, you can see seal function, square root function. If you want to find the sqrt, you can see the second one in the slide. Okay, if you want to find the square root, means using the square root sqrt function, we can use it. An exp function, exponential function, fabs, that is fab means getting the limit of the things, floor, lower limit of the number, log value. Have you used log value in physics or chemistry? In mathematics also, have you used the logarithmic chapter before? Have you studied in the 10th standard?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, good. Then you know that log 10 means what? Base is 10. That is a decimal. We will get the number. Okay. Log 10, power of means that is finding the 2 power 3, 2 power 4, 2 power 10. Okay, that is means we are getting the power. Sine, cos, tan. Have you heard that? Where you heard that? 10 standard, have you trigonometry?
Sine, cos, tan, trigonometry values.
Yes, these are all the trigonometry values. So if you want to, for example, if you want to know sine 45, what is the number? If you want to easily calculate, it means already the functions are, the code is already defined. Defined means return. That's the meaning of defined. Hereafter, we have to use the word defined means already return. Okay. Where it is written, sir? It is already written and stored in the module math. Okay. That is the thing. JLK, you typed something and I didn't get your 7458. What is the thing? Okay. Let us just see that. Okay. These are all the functions are defined in the, apart from that, these are all the example only. They given that it is an important function. Apart from that, the n number of functions also, I mean not n number, few more functions also defined in the math library. Math is one of the library in the Python. Likewise, string library is there, random library is there. Okay, likewise, many n number of libraries are there. What is the library will contain means n number of functions. These are all function. I already said that whenever you are seeing the open parenthesis and close parenthesis means we should pronounce it is a function. The two parentheses there, no, together if you want to pronounce means, we should not say seal open parenthesis, close parenthesis. We should not say like that. We have to say what? Seal function, sqrt function, exp function, okay? In that cos function, tan function, like that only we have to use, okay? Apart from that, in the function, these are all the functions are important. We might use in regular days, okay? That is for mathematical purpose, if you want to find any trigonometrical values means, once you done the program means very easy. Math and all, you can easily, you apply the value means the computer itself will tell the result. Okay. But not steps and all, it won't do. It will tell the result only. Okay. So we can check it, whether the math sums and all. For example, now you are doing very more math sum. No. Once you learn how to write the program in Python means, for all the sums, if you write the program means very easy. If you simply enter the values means, okay. Any equation values, if you enter means that's all. What is the thing? Automatically the program will tell the what is the answer. Okay, it will be for just for it's not fun, we can do it. Okay, that's what I'm saying. Just for checking purpose. Okay. So these are all the math libraries, functions are there. Let me discuss one by one. In our real-time problem, we will come to know it. Okay, these are all the things are there in your concept. Okay. So let me go to the program. Next one. Have you understand this concept? The 8th chapter. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So in this 8th chapter, what are the things we discussed? I mean, 8th chapter means I'm talking about the, in your book, it is what chapter? There is 8th chapter only. Yes. Have you understand these things? Operators in your book, if you are having the book in you means you can see this data types are there. And next is mutable and immutable operators. We already discussed the operator. Have you remember arithmetic operator, relation operator, identity operator, logical operator, bitwise operator, operator precedence also we discussed. An expression, how to evaluate the expression means very simple. I will show the slide to you. 1 minute. That's alone is pending. And debugging is there. For 6th chapter, if you understand means, you can easy, that I will teach means you can understand it. 1 minute. This is the operator precedence. Okay. For example, these are all types of operator. Operator precedence is different. I will show in the next slide. I will create the slide and I will show to you. Okay. These are all the operator we already discussed. Can you remember it? Identity operator, is or not in. That is, is and not, is not equal to operator. Membership operator we discussed. In and not in. I will remember that greater than or equal to. How to put the equal to symbol, not equal to symbol. Floor division. We understand. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, fine. So good. So these are all the major concepts in the 8th chapter. We almost complete the 8th chapter. Only one topic is there. That is operator precedence and operator how to do the logical expressions. Okay, that is very important topic also too. Tomorrow I will teach that concept. Let me do some program in the Python. Okay. So I've just opened the
tomorrow class, sir.
Tomorrow means Monday, man. Tomorrow you have exam, no? I mean test. Don't forget about the test. Tomorrow you have the test on data representation. Okay, that is chapter 2, number system. Number system.
I know, sir.
10 o'clock, but 10 o'clock. I just mentioned in the even in the WhatsApp group also. 10 o'clock exactly, the question will be posted in our WhatsApp group. You just by clicking the link, you can start to answer the questions. Okay, if just read the instruction very properly. Okay, whether they are asking to type in the capital letter or small letter, because the answer will be it is not a manual correction. Automatically, the computer will do the correction, no, based on the answers which I fit. Okay. So it will take it. Okay, that's what the type in capital means. Completely type in capital letters, the full forms and all. So go through the instruction and you can start to write the second assessment. Okay, that is the second chapter, data representation. Okay, today I give that is long back I given the homework for grocery, how to produce the bill. Okay, I mean generate the bill. I hope many of them done the homework. Okay, very nice. Anybody having doubt on that? Anybody having doubt regarding the grocery things?
No,
you
sir. Means,
you can ask it, I will teach. Okay. Or else shall we
no,
use
sir.
Math library function. Okay. So for example, how to use the square root and exponential power function and all. If you want to print means very easy. For example, for that, how to use the math. I said that, sir, math libraries contain a number of functions. How to use means we need to import that module. Okay, import the library. Okay, we need to import the library. For that, we have to use one keyword. Listen very carefully. Import. You can see I am typing in the screen. Import math. Okay, sorry. Okay, import math. If I give means, all the math library will be get imported. Okay, that is the first thing. And second concept is, now if I want to use the square root function. Okay, I want to find the square root for certain numbers. Okay, I will just get a number from the user. How to get the number? First, I want to print the square root program. How can I print it? Can you see? I want to display square root program. What is the statement? Hello? Print. Okay. See, children, I am saying that today, program is very important. Theory, they will not ask questions. For 11th you may see some theory questions, but 12th standard there is 0% theory questions only. Only program only asker. Okay, concentrate more on programs, practice more. Okay, side by side. Now we are learning the theory. Once we complete it means learn the practicals. Okay, one more minute is there. Join immediately with the using the same link. Okay, whenever the meeting is completed means. Okay, rejoin it immediately. Okay, meanwhile I am typing it. Okay, print. What is the thing we need to print? Square root program, no? Okay. Square root program. Okay. I'm just typing that. So I just typed it. It will be printed. Okay. Now I want to get the number from the user. How to get the input from the user? You already done, no? In your homework. Just I want to revamp you. How you done your homework? Sort of thing. That is, I am just changing into the square root calculator. Okay, this is the program to calculate the square root. Okay, square root of the entered number. So now I want to get the number from user. What is the statement? What is the code I want to write? How to write the input statement? We need a variable, no? I am just giving n is one variable. N equal to, I want to get the number, integer number. Okay, int of, then input. Input of, then what is the thing? Enter the number. Enter a number. Okay. Likewise, we can give a state. We can give a things. Okay. Now the entered number will be stored into the variable n. I have very strong doubt whether you understand the concept of variable and how to get the input and how to print the statement. Because for the three things, you are not at all answering so far. Because this is a very fundamental, very basic. It's a true basic for that. If you don't know the input statement, output statement, and variable declaration means, you cannot do the upcoming programs. You will be simply, you will be quiet. How you are quieting in the, be silent in the class, that only you have to follow till the long. I have very strong doubt. Have you understand that? how to get the input and output.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, because I have seen some of the homeworks, very silly mistakes. Comma is missed. Double quotes is missed. Okay, that is not a big thing because I really appreciate first time you only are typing the things, you will definitely get a mistake. Not only the first time. Even sometimes I am typing that you can see literally many mistakes will come. One spelling mistake, we may, by ignorance we will type it. Okay, or else what is the thing? We may press the key, suppose the content is not properly printed. Okay, that may be another reason also too. Okay, so mistake is okay, but what is the thing? You want to know that, okay, how to give these things and all. Okay, that is very important. I have very strong doubt whether you people are good in the content or not. Please be thorough it, then you can come to know it. Okay. Okay, let me see that. So we got the input from the user. Now we need to find the square root of the given number. Okay, how to find, sir? So I'm just using sc equal to one variable, sc equal to math dot, because the square root function is where it is defined. It is defined in the library math, isn't it? So math dot sqrt. Okay, sqrt of which number we need to find? For which number we need to find the square root? N number. N is a number, no? The user given some N number that will be stored in the variable N, no? Isn't it? So I have to give N. Okay. So if I use this, means S will, the S variable contains the square root of the given number. Now we need to print the value. Okay. So print of, I'm just giving print. Okay. So I'm just giving the square root of the given number is, likewise I can just print it. Okay, then where it is, this what I'm just using this, you can see many of them done the mistake in this part. I open the double quotes, I should close the double quotes. Okay, suppose I want to print the variable, means I should use comma. Okay, then variable, which variable I want to print? The S variable. Okay, now you can see this. Now I have to close the bracket also. Okay, I'm just saving this file. In the desktop itself, I'm just saving. I'm just using the word sqrt. Okay, dot, what is the file extension for Python? What is the extension for Python file? How to save the file? File name dot?
11.
11 only, whether if we give 12, it will show any error. No man, I'm asking the extension. What is the extension for that? .py. .py is the extension. We have stored, no, class 11 also. So try to understand this. Okay. sqrt.py is stored it. Now I have to run the file. What is the command to run the file? Or which? What is the shortcut key to run the file? How to run
the file?
Okay, good. I'm just pressing the F5. Yes,
right.
You can see it is asking the, at last you can see this, square root calculator, enter the number. I will just close this screen once again for you, and then again I will open it. Okay. So okay, I'm running again. You can see this. It is asking square root calculator, enter number. Okay. Suppose I just given 25. What is the square root of 25? Hello, don't you know that? For that only
five,
I have an easy question. Yeah.
Five.
Suppose if you enter, means it is showing that the square root of the given number is 5.0. Good, no? So likewise, whatever number if you give, it will calculate it. Okay. For example, I'm just checking. Can you say any one number? Can you say any one number?
36.
This enter means 6 will come. Okay. So likewise, it is not necessary to be a two-digit number, three-digit number, whatever number if you give, it will easily calculate. Okay, sir, where the function, sir, how it will do the calculation, sir, whether we are done anything means we didn't do anything. The square root function, I already said sqrt is the function. Okay, we are pronounced square root. Okay, the sqrt function, all the codes are defined. Okay, this is a function. How to define your function, that you will learn at the last part. That is in 12th standard. You can create your own functions also. Okay. So in this function, if you open the function, means the code is there. Okay. So for code, how to find the square root, already it is written. Okay, it is returned where it is stored. It is stored in the library. Library is otherwise called as module. Okay, it is stored in the library called math. Okay, math library already it was stored. No, we have seen the slide. No, okay. So already it is stored. So we are using it. How to use, sir? First we need to import. Import the math library. That is, import the math library means we are using. We, if you want to use, means we need to create a link between the math library. Import math. Okay. Then second thing you can see this. You are, you know, the print statement and the input statement. Okay. Third line you can see s equal to math dot sqrt of n. So that is, s is a variable. We can give whatever variable also in order to store the value. Okay. Math dot sqrt. Y means where the function is defined in the math library. Okay. So math I used. Dot is a dot operator. Okay. Dot, which function? What is the function? Square root is the function. Okay. That function only we can able to find the square root. No. So square root, for what purpose, for what number we need to find the square root, that number we need to pass. That is, n is a number. No. N is what? Enter a number, that number will be stored in the variable n. No. Isn't it? Am I right? Hello?
Yes, sir.
That n will be stored into the the variable contains some number whenever we are passing. So the function will calculate the result and it will use to the, and it will be, the result will be stored in the variable s. Okay. Now you can see the last line, print the square root of the given number. It will be just to print. We are printing the s because the s is contains the result of the given number. No, that's what the thing is. Have you understand that, how to find the square root by using the module, math module? And today you learned what are the type, that is the type casting, type conversion, two type of conversion, id function, value function. We discussed module, math module we have seen, and we have done some example program also, how to find the square root also, isn't it? Suppose let me
math library.
Yeah, math library, that is the math module or library. Good. So these are all the things we have learned. So shall we do the another one example program? Square root is there, power of, suppose if you want to find the power of certain number means, shall we write the program? For example, I want to know the 5 power 10. What is the answer? Is it very difficult? No, to calculate. Difficult means we need to do it. 5 into 5, we know 25. 25 into 5, 125. 125 into 5, what is the thing? Is it 625? Yeah. Likewise, if it is goes means we can calculate by manually, by orally, up to the power of cube. Okay, square we can find, cube we can find, power of 4 sometimes we can find. For example, number 2 and all we can easily find. Okay, suppose I'm asking 2 power 20, whether it is possible by tell immediately. We are not Shakuntala Devi, no. I send one video. Have you seen that?
Yes, sir.
He is said such a genius person who, she will easily calculate the value, whatever number if you are saying means. Okay. So that's what the world itself, from the world, he is the only one person having the ability. Okay. So far we learnt it. I mean, we come to know it. Okay. So that's what they given the title is, human computer. She is she was the human computer, or that much of capacity or memory capacity is that much she can do the calculations. Okay. From this is a child prodigy. We are saying, no, prodigy means it's a very extraordinary person. Okay, it's moreover the brilliant. Okay, so from the child onwards, she is not learning the abacus. Somebody said that in between some rumors also. So I came to know some of the abacus company is there. No, they given the things. Oh, she learned the abacus in the childhood days. That's what she is. That much of memory capacity, skills and all she was developed. Likewise, they using the wrong information, but it is not actually from the childhood days onwards. She is not going for any abacus class, just normal school class only, but naturally, that is the born, it's a born intelligence. Okay. That's what.
God gift.
Yeah, of course. She's a gifted person. Good. Very good. Okay. Let me find the square roots of power of some numbers. Shall we do the program for that? Hello. Now you have to tell the number. Don't say.
Yes, sir.
Now we need to find the power calculator. Just we are giving some title. Okay, nothing wrong with it. Power or exponential calculator. Okay, this e power 2. What is power calculator? I'm just giving the title. Did you see? We want to get the two numbers. One is base number and next one is exponential term, isn't it? E power 3. What is E? 2 power 3 means 3, 2 cube means what? 2 is the base number. 3 is, that is cube is what? That's power. Have you understand? So we want to get the two numbers as the input. Can you say the input statement? What is the input statement? First we need to get the base number. Base number, shall we give the B is a variable? Shall we give? Hello? The people are... you have to tell the answer, man. I'm just shouting like anything, but you people are not at all answering. Means I have a very strong doubt. Just like that, the TV you are watching. Likewise, what I'm teaching, what I'm just asking.
No, sir.
And then you have to tell, no? Okay, shall I give the... All the peoples, Rajesh something, sometimes he is answering. Another one girl is there, I think, I forgot the name. Who's that? Okay, that girl is answering. Apart from that, I didn't get anybody answer from anybody. Okay, just tell the things, what are the variable? I'm just giving B equal to one variable, B equal to getting the base number. Okay, so it should be integer, no? So I'm just giving int of. Okay, input. Input is a string, no? Input of enter the base number. Okay? So, I'm just teaching children, you didn't listen or you didn't say along with me, you didn't answer with me, that is, you didn't interact with me means you will not get the Python. That's what I'm sure. I will give on a paper, I will return in the paper and give to you also. That much I have the assurance. If you didn't answer properly means the class is not interactive means. You will struggle a lot in the future, in the next year and all. That's what we interact with. That's what I'm again and again I'm saying that for your sake only. My children should not be suffer at any cost. That's the mindset of me. Just do not understand that. If I'm asking the question means you people are not at all answering. Okay. So you enter the base number, we got that input. Okay, next we need to get the exponential value. So what variable shall I give? Shall I give E? E is a variable to get. To power, isn't it? So I'm just getting the using the same thing. Can you say the what is the query I have to type? I mean command I want to type. Int of. Okay, very nice. Hereafter I won't ask anything from you. I will type it. 3 to 4. I will take the likewise live class and it's not live class. How the video want to be there? Just like that, you can see the video. That's all. Whether you learnt or not, it's up to you. Okay. I'm asking, you are not saying that. You are not at all unmute your mic also. You are not saying that. I don't know what is the reason. Okay, enter the power value. Enter the power or exponential value. I'm just using for understanding power number or exponential value. Okay, better I will type exponential. Exponent, okay, or exponential value. I'm just giving that. Okay, so now we got the two inputs by using the statement. We didn't get literally, but in using the code, we will get it. Okay, that's what I'm coming to tell. Now we need to calculate the power, no? So how to use the power? For example, result we want to store, no? I'm using R as a variable to store the result. Okay, so where the power function is defined? From the math library. So I have to use math. Okay, dot, what is the function? POW is the function. Okay. In that, what is the base number? B is the base number. What is the exponential number? E power, that is 2 power 3 means 2 is the base number, E is 3 is a exponential number. So I just given, have you understand? So I just stored into the variable R, then I'm just using the print statement, and in the print statement, I'm just typing that the result is, okay. Result is, likewise, we can print whatever we required, okay. So, comma, what we need to print? R we need to print, no? So, I'm just using it. Okay, I saved this file. Again, I'm running. You can see this. Enter the power. Okay, base number it is asking. I'm just entering 2. What is the exponential? It is asking. I'm entering 3. Okay, now you can see. 2 power 3 is what? 8, no? Have you understand? Have you understood this?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Again, I'm just running. For you. You can see this. Suppose I'm just giving the enter, I want number 8. Okay, 8 power 8, I want to know. What is the value? 8 is 64, 64 into 8, again that value into 8, we need to multiply with 8 times. Okay, if you just give a number, see that much of number, what is the thing? It is crores or lakhs. Can you calculate it? I think 1 crore 67 lakh, isn't it? 7,000, oh, it's not, 67, oh. Can you say that? 1 crore 67 lakh.
67,000.
67,000? No, ma.
67,216.
Good. Yes. So that was the value. Okay. This is possible by human to calculate the 8 power 8 means. Of course, we can possible, but time will be taken more, isn't it? We need to do the multiplication. No, that much time. So whatever, if you are thorough in the table also, if you are learning the abacus also, I mean, I'm saying that, I'm not discouraging you. So you can take at least 1 minute, at least a second, but the computer will easily, it will do it. Okay. For that and all, it already, the function is defined. See how much line I just, this is a real line. The one line, no, I highlighted R equal to math dot power of B comma E. Just to give the two number automatically, it will tell it. That's all. Is it easy? No. To see the calculating the power and exponential. Not only that, many things are there. We can define our own function also. Okay. So that and all we will learn in the 12th standard. Okay. Now we are in this year, we are going to see about the basics and of all the data types of the Python. Okay. So basic things we are going to learn. And 8th chapter, this current chapter, if you're having the book means you can come to know. Debugging one concept is there. Error in the program, debugging using code tracing. Okay. That concept is lively, we can see it. I'm not taking the theory part. I'm not going to take the theory part of the concept. If you are having the book means, you can see that. Literally, we can see. If I do the error means, how the error will come, how to solve the error. Okay. In live classly, we will discuss it. Okay. Whenever in the offline, I mean, offline means the school itself or else in online class also, whatever it is. We will discuss literally. Okay. Have you understood, students? This concept?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, good.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So just to go through this program again, I mean the video again, it will be shortly available in YouTube. So go through it and materials, I already posted in our website. Kindly click the material tab. You can find this material, which I am using to teach. Okay. By using that, you can prepare it. And Tomorrow, 10 o'clock, you are having the test. Don't forget it. All the 16 members who is in the class now, just remember that. Please inform to other friends also. Okay. Once again, I will put the reminder message also. And tomorrow, 10 o'clock, sharply the question paper, you will get the link. Okay. So just click the link. You have the same thing. Valid email, Gmail account. Gmail ID you need. Email ID. So just it will ask the username and password. Once you log in, means that's all. You can easily answer it. One by one, you can answer it. Immediately, you can get the answers also. Okay. You can verify that whether the what answer you return, what is the right answer, how much mark it is allotted. Immediately, the Google form, it will be reflect to you. Okay. That is the concept. All the best for tomorrow class. Prepare well and use the smart OneNote we used, you know, that is I'm typing. I'm just drawing, you know, I return on the notes. You know, the return notes also, I uploaded in the website. How many of you seen or have doubt? All the numerical sums we dealt in the classroom, no? There is an online. So all the notes I just posted, converted into the PDF file, I posted it. Just refer it, all the notes, and I have asked to write in the classwork also. Okay, that notes also, and many ASCII codes, everything is available in our website. Okay, make use of it. This website is, I already mentioned that it is meant for you only. Okay, not for any other purpose. Only for students, they want to get some benefit in the computer science. Okay. Being a computer science teacher, I've taken a very small effort for that. In 12th standard also, the people are getting the more benefits. Okay. Likewise, you will also, whenever we started to use continuously, you will come to know it will be very easy and very handy also to make use of it. Okay. If you want to refer the videos also, all the video class, I didn't do any editing. Whatever it is completely recorded and it is posting it. Okay. That will give an interface to you. That's what. Okay, students, very nice and spending time with you. See you all on Monday. Okay, thank you to all.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.